Dog bite. When a patient presents with history of dog bite, the most important thing to know is whether the dog was affected by rabies or not. Because only a rabid dog can transmit rabies through his saliva. To know this, we must observe the dog for 5 days. If the dog is alive and normal, that is behaving normally at the end of 5 days, then there is no cause for worry. If the dog is rabid, that is in an infective stage of rabies, it will definitely behave abnormally and definitely die within 5 days. And this is the most reliable evidence to decide whether the dog is infected or not. But if it is a stray dog, unknown dog, or if the dog is killed without observing whether it is rabid, then you must presume that it was infected by rabies and give a full course of immunization. This is because rabies has no treatment once it develops. The only thing we can do is to prevent it by giving anti-rabies vaccine. So if the dog is unknown, untraceable, then don't take any chance. Give full course of anti-rabies vaccine. The second important thing to consider is the nature of the wound. Please remember that even the slightest scratch is enough for rabies virus to enter the person's body from the dog's saliva. If the dog was affected by rabies, don't say wound is very small or it is not a bite mark, it is a scratch mark. Even if the scratches are caused by dog's paws, a drop of saliva may fall on it and cause rabies. So do not take any chances. Always immunize the patient against rabies whenever the dog is rabid or an unknown stray dog. Large wounds or wounds on the face and scalp are more prone to cause rabies, and that too with a shorter incubation period. So in these cases, that is wounds of the face and scalp and large multiple wounds, not even a day should be wasted to start the vaccine. Give the first dose immediately. And now let us consider the treatment of the wound. Wash the wound immediately and thoroughly with soap solution or Savlon and plenty of water. Wash it repeatedly under flowing water. If the wound is large, deep, or very likely to be infected, then the local treatment is very important. First, infiltrate local xylocaine around the wound so that it becomes painless, and then scrub it thoroughly. After washing, paint it with povidone iodine or 70% alcohol. Next, infiltrate 1 cc of rabies immunoglobulin around the wound and apply a small amount of it to the wound surface. Note that we are infiltrating rabies immunoglobulin, not the anti-rabies vaccine like Rabipure. This is Berirab 300 international units in 1 ml ampule. The smaller CLWs are not sutured. Do a open dressing. But if the CLW is large and gaping, then suture it loosely after debriding the edges and keep a drain. Next, we will come to the immunization schedule. Before we discuss that, let us keep in mind some facts about rabies. Number 1, rabies has no known treatment. So the only way to fight it is by immunizing the patient in time before the disease develops. Number 2, though normally incubation period is 1 to 2 months, rabies can develop within 10 days. So the immunization should start immediately without wasting even a day. Number 3, rabies can occur after several months or years also. So you should never have a false sense of security. The immunization is achieved by giving cell culture vaccines in the prescribed dose. Give injection Rabipure 1 ml intramuscularly 6 doses. The first dose is given immediately and counted as day 0. Subsequent doses are given on days 3, 7, 14, 30 and 90. Suppose the dog appears normal and is under observation, then give the first two doses, that is day 0 and day 3. And then on 7th day, if the dog is normal, then stop the immunization. One very important point to remember here is that the dose is same for children and infants also. Unlike other vaccines, there is no half dose. Even in children, full vial, that is 1 ml, should be injected intramuscularly. Now, since we are giving the anti-rabies vaccine to develop active immunity, a few days period is needed for the immunity to develop. But what if rabies develops within this small period? Yes, this risk is definitely existing. So if the patient has multiple and deep bites from a rabid dog, or bites on the face and neck, or if the patient has come to you 2 to 3 days after the bite, then give immediate protection with hyperimmune serum, that is injection Berirab, 20 international units per kg body weight. So an average adult weighing 60 kg will require 1200 international units, that is 4 ml of Berirab. Of this, 3 ml is given intramuscularly, but away from the site where Rabipur is given. If Rabipur is given in right buttock, give hyperimmune serum, that is Berirab, in the left buttock. The remaining 1 ml of the dose is infiltrated around the wound and applied locally. The dose schedule of Rabipur will remain as per schedule. No extra dose is required because the hyperimmune serum is given. Lastly, let me tell you a word about pre-exposure vaccination. Some professions are exposed to rabies virus frequently. For example, veterinary surgeons, veterinary students, technical and laboratory persons working in veterinary hospital, persons working in slaughterhouses, persons working in forestry, parks and zoos, and of course, rural postmen. Such persons who are at high risk of dog bites should be advised immunization with 3 doses of a cell culture vaccine on day 1, 7 and 28. Day 1, 7 and 28. This should be followed by booster doses after 1 year and then once in 3 years. If such immunized person gets a dog bite, then only one booster injection of Rabipur is required. But if he was immunized more than 1 year back, then 3 injections are given on day 1, 3 and 7.